It was late December. Alita, my wife, and I, we took a ride across the intercoastal to the northern end of Jupiter Island just to have a nice walk on the beach. We headed south for, I don't know, half a mile or so. And then when we came back, I smelled the smell of death. So I went up into the dune, and there I saw a decomposed manatee. I mean, you could even see the bones in its flippers. The skin was all intact. What was left reminded me very much of what you would see an elephant on the plains of Africa that had been dyed and decomposed. The manatees are actually related, very close relative to the elephant. So it was very sad seeing this. Most recently, we've had a tremendous issue with the water quality and seagrass dying off. And the seagrass is the primary food for the manatee. The manatees are literally starving to death here locally. Fish and Wildlife Foundation's working around the clock on ways to replant the seagrass beds. They're also enabling a new programs to feed the manatees, and they're trying to do it where they don't get the manatees dependent upon people. I'm always, I'm the optimist, and I think, one thing's for sure, when given the chance, Mother Nature always recovers. As a large marine mammal that has no natural enemies, they're curious, they're playful, they're social. They're like us. They're a very, very graceful and beautiful animal. And they, I love depicting them in my art. I've sculpted several different manatees. I've got one nice tabletop piece of a mother and calf swimming. It's kind of a vertical piece. It's really a beautiful piece. And then that was kind of a maquette for the big one that we did that's out at Florida Oceanographic. On the top are a pair of big loggerhead turtles, and then these two life-size manatees, and it comes into a big base that's got octopuses and sharks and snook and all kinds of fish in it. So behind the studio, there's a canal that connects to the manatee pocket. We took all the invasive pepper trees out, and then we replanted the whole area in native plants. We planted over 700 different native plants. As winter came and it got colder, the manatees came into the canal to stay in the warm water. And so one day behind the studio in the preserve, I spotted something I'd never seen before. The manatees were actually lifting themselves with their front flippers up and eating the salt marsh cordgrass that we planted along the shoreline, and they would actually eat the mangrove trees too. It was pretty neat. There was, at one point, 6-7 manatees in there. I was very excited when they were eating, and I thought, wow, we've really made a difference here, and this is great. So much so, the local Channel 5, Megan McRoberts, came and did a little news story on it. I was really thinking that we had helped with the problem with the manatees of their starving to death, with now we've got, the stuff we planted, it's growing, they're eating it. But then I started doing the math, and then I, kind of put two and two together in my head that 100 pounds of seagrass is what a full-grown manatee needs to eat. There's not 100 pounds, there. So it's like they're getting an hors d'oeuvre, but, it's not enough. So wanting to investigate more and learn more about the manatees, we got with some friends of ours and we took a trip over to Homosassa Springs. So the first morning I went out, and it was the temperature was in the 40s, and I was on my paddleboard, and the steam was coming off the water, and it was absolutely gorgeous, and I couldn't believe it. Within about a 10-minute paddle, all of a sudden I was in the mother load of manatees. They were everywhere. It's amazing when you're underwater and the sunlight, the sun's coming down, shining through the water and reflecting off the manatees, and it makes these different patterns. It's absolutely gorgeous. I'd be backing up to get the whole manatee in the picture. And then another one would come up behind you and rub up against your back. And you think you're gonna spook them or something, but they're very playful animals, and they come right up to you. It's really neat. At one point, I tied my paddleboard up, and then I was swimming around with the manatees, and Alita, she was on another paddleboard, and she kept having to paddle with the current, and she said to me, "Geez, we should have brought an anchor." You know, I didn't think anything of it. It's like, yeah, we should have brought an anchor. And then I was filming and swimming, and I see this manatee go down to the bottom, and it picked up a rope in its paws. And then it's laying there, and it takes the rope, and it puts it in its mouth, and it starts chewing on it. And I said, okay. And then I look down the line, and then I see some chain and a shiny, brand new anchor. So I swam over there, and the manatee handed me the line, and I pulled it up, and now we got a slightly oversized anchor for a paddleboard. The natural resources of Florida are so vast and unlimited. Conserving these beautiful manatees and their habitat, the seagrass, the clean water, not only benefits them, but in the end, it really benefits us as we're all connected. These gentle giants are an indicator of the overall health of our environment, and we all need to do our part to make it better for them and for us.